Maxie. Thanks everyone for being here. It is quite an honor for me to be the co-chair of this event. I have attended this event for 16 years, and my, has it grown. It's grown in the number of people that attend. It's grown in the sectors of the legal community that we're recognizing at this event. More than 16 years ago, legal services was the province of legal service organizations. It then became the province of large law firm pro bono programs. And my dad's firm, Sidley & Austin, and other firms stepped up and led by example. I'm proud, particularly proud today, that we have represented in the awardees members of in-house legal departments. We have two of the lawyers that are from outside law firms that are winning awards there from small law firms. That is a wonderful reflection on the evolution of this community, that all parts of the community are contributing in their own unique ways to this cause that we all so strongly believe in. I'm also had the pleasure this year of sitting in not just on the Morsch Award Committee selection, but on the selection of most of the other awards. And the breadth of work that is being done is really quite amazing. There are many people who will recognize in future years that didn't win awards. But if you think just about the people that we're going to acknowledge in today's luncheon, think about the issues that we're covering through them. Issues ranging from human trafficking to housing, to representing the accused on appeal, to representing the formerly incarcerated and letting them return to full and productive lives, to representing the victims of domestic abuse, to representing persons in probably the civil rights issue of our era, namely fair equality in marriage. These recipients reflect the best of all of us.